I want first to thank all the organizer, and the organizer of this event, and all supporters. I want to tell you very clearly that all organizations of people of African descent in Germany demand the German government to officially recognize the genocides and war crimes committed in Africa. This point is so important that it was included in the constitution of the Central Council of the African Community in Germany as one of the main objectives of the organization. It is in this perspective that we work with all the actors and the civil society to bring the German government to make a commitment to rewrite the history of the country by integrating this element. We demand the rewriting of the school books in cooperation with experts of the African community. After several years of hesitation and denial, the German government began to change its paradigm. It began to give up its definition of what he cynically called event of Namibia or act of war in Namibia. Under the pressure of communities Ovaherero, Nama, Damara, and San, the resolution of the Namibian parliament, the strong pressure of the African diaspora and the movement of the German civil society, the German government made the first step in the right direction. What took place in the German colony Namibia was genocide. Yes, Germany committed the first genocide on the 20th century against Herero and Nama. Instead of driving the conclusion of initiating negotiation with the representatives of the victims, the German government chose the way of the arrogance by trying to play the interests of the Namibian government against the interests of the victim by not inviting the representative of the victim in negotiation. We want to assert here that with you, we shall accept no deal with both governments if they do not recognize the following points. First, the German government recognizes the genocide against Herero and Nama and gives an official excuse to the victim. Second, the German government pay compensation, the amount of which will be negotiated with the representative of the victim. We say compensation and not development aid or other term with here and not development aid or other term which hides the link between the paid sums and the genocide. Raising awareness of the opinion by appropriate way, major school cultural events on the German colonization. Fourth, rehabilitation of the people victim of genocide by the construction of monument, appointments of street, in other words, a culture of the just memory. On this Congress, we hope that we shall send a very strong signal to the German and Namibian government. An agreement between the German government and Namibian government without the representative of the Herero will never be accepted by the African diaspora and the victims. Together, we forced the German government to recognize the genocide against Herero. We will force them to negotiate with the representative of the Herero. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Moctar Kamara. I would like to introduce to you, just a second, Ms. Elisabeth Kaneza. She's fellow of the UN Decade for People of African Descent, and I've seen her around, so you might come over here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Dear distinguished guests, Member of Parliaments, dear chiefs, dear representatives of civil society of the Nama and Herero present, ladies and gentlemen, protocol observed, Today, I'm very pleased to speak to you on the occasion of this very important Congress, and I'm very happy to represent the International Decade for People of African Descent, which I represent here today. I would like to start my speech by delivering the statement of the United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon on the International Decade for People of African Descent. Beginning of quote, "Across the globe, Africans and the African diaspora continue to suffer inequality and disadvantage because of the legacy of slavery and colonialism. Freedom from violence, prejudice, and discrimination are a distant dream for many. People of African descent are amongst the poorest and most marginalized communities around the world. They have high rates of mortality and maternal deaths, and limited access to quality education, health services, housing, and social security. They may experience discrimination in their access to justice, and they face alarmingly high rates of police violence and racial profiling. We all need to do more to ensure fairness in justice and law enforcement systems, and promote and uphold the human rights of people of African descent. This decade is an opportunity for focused and concerted action. My hope is that a decade from now, the human rights situation of people of African descent worldwide will be vastly improved." End of quote. Ladies and gentlemen, the International Decade for People of African Descent was proclaimed for the years 2015 until 2024. It is the first decade ever tasked with promoting the human rights of people of African descent. It is also the first decade ever that seeks recognition for past and current human rights violations committed against the African family. It is the first decade ever that has the mandate to restore dignity, historical truth, and which seeks justice for people of African descent. As such, the decade is by far, one of the most significant victories which we celebrate on our long struggle towards freedom and justice. So we have gathered here today to commemorate and reflect on the Ovaherero and Nama genocides. These genocides happened in our recent past, yet they remain marginalized and unknown to many. To not recognize a genocide or to deny it, a genocide which is in fact not a human rights violation, but a crime against humanity. To not recognize it and to deny it, it is like killing the dead again. And until we restore dignity for the victims and their descendants, no justice can be done. And I say this to you as a survivor of one of the most tragic events in contemporary history. Born and raised in Rwanda, I know very well what it means to fight for recognition and justice long after a genocide took place and the dead have been buried. And I know the value we have as a people in the eyes of the world. In my case, I realized very early I simply happened to have the wrong skin color and resided on the wrong side of the planet for the eyes of the world, which watched more than 1 million people perish and did not move a finger to rescue innocent people, the African people. This is our shared legacy. And I want now to come to the point what it means to have a genocide against an African people, and what it takes to actually talk about the big word reparation, because I hear it very often, the big word reparation. So let me introduce you to something from the UN system, which makes it very difficult to fight and actually to win the battle which we're fighting. So there are some criteria on how we can achieve reparation in the framework of the UN decade. The number one criteria, the justice must be well documented, the injustice. Number two, These are criteria for reparation. Number two, the victims must be identified as a distinct group. Number three, the current members of the group must be continued to suffer the harm. So now, in our case, looking at the genocide in Namibia, you can see and reflect on whether you can either tick one, two, or three. We have a big issue here, and I will tell you why. Then, back then and now, we stand alone, our humanity being questioned. Why else do we have to share our stories today? Why else do we have a decade for African descent today in 2016? Ladies and gentlemen, I feel that our humanity is once again questioned when we are asked to fulfill this criteria, while it is clear why we have no documentation on the crimes committed against people of African descent. I feel our humanity is questioned when we are offered charity in exchange for silence. But let me tell you clearly, no payment transfer from Germany could ever undo the harm done to an entire people. Let me say clearly again that the international decade is a reparation decade. However, we are not so little minded as to believe that aid can replace the responsibility for a crime against humanity. Have you ever heard of a crime against humanity which has no monument? Have you ever heard of a crime without a monument? Germany, with other states, have signed the Declaration of Durban, which recognizes enslavement and colonialism as crimes against humanity. Yet, the African and Black experience remains without a monument. 400 to 500 years of oppression, enslavement, undocumented, unrecognized, and unspoken. So what I want to say today is that we demand recognition first, we demand respect, we demand justice for the atrocities, for the unthinkable harm done to the women and men of Nama and Herero. And I welcome your initiative and efforts to realize this Congress, and I invite all of us to take the demands of the decade of recognition, justice, and development into account when we discuss today the nature and the scope of compensation or reparations we want. And I want us to be reminded by this list of criteria, true or untrue. So it is my wish that our conclusions today dignify the history and legacy of the Nama and the Herero, and that they manifest our shared humanity. Thank you very much for your attention.